In this short video, I'm going to give you some practical advice on the selection of a pump for your NFT system. I'll also show you how easy it is to do the calculations.
Let's do it.
There's only a few parameters that's important in pump selection. The first parameter is the amount of water that we must move in a specific time period. That can be in either liter or gallon per hour. If we only need to lift a small amount of water, we can get away with a smaller pump. And obviously, if we need to lift more water in a given time period, then we need a bigger pump. Our second parameter is how high the pump must lift the water. And for that, we use a normal measuring tape. So we measure from the lowest point that the water can be in the system up until the highest point where the pump must lift the water. The next parameter to consider is the friction in the pipe. And the friction in a small diameter pipe will be much more than the friction in a larger diameter pipe. So from this we can learn that the larger diameter pipe will have less friction and it's much better to use than a smaller diameter pipe. Another thing that will influence the friction of the water in the pipe is the length of the pipe. There will, for instance, be a lot more friction in a longer pipe than in a shorter pipe. The first thing that's important when you want to buy a pump is the pump curve. Now let's have a look at a typical pump curve. Now this is a typical pump chart that you'll use in the selection of the pump. There's two pumps indicated on this chart, a DDF50 and a DDF110. This is the characteristic curve of the DDF50 and that one of the DDF110. On our vertical axis, we will have the head of the pump. That's how high the pump must lift the water. On our horizontal axis, we will have the flow rate. And in this case, it's indicated in cubic meter per hour. Now you may ask, we've got the height that we lift the water and we've got the flow rate, but what about the friction in the pipe? How do we calculate that? Easy way for small systems is just to add 20% to your height. Let's consider this very simple NFT system. NFT system is a nutrient film technology. So it means the pump will pump the water up and just a small film of water will be at the bottom of the pipe and the roots of the plants that's in these holes in the NFT system will then reach to that water and that's how they will get their nutrients. The flow rate in a single NFT pipe in a hydroponic system is normally between 10 and 25 liters per hour. The slope for an NFT system is normally 2 to 4%. That means it must fall 2 to 4 centimeters per meter length of the pipe. Now we need to consider how high must we lift the water in the system. And remember, it's from the lowest point that the water can go up until the highest point where the pump must take the water. So it will be from this point, the absolute lowest point that it can go in the sump. If you think your point is a little bit lower, then you move your measure from there. Up until the highest point that the water must be lifted. Not the highest point in your system, but the highest point where the water must be lifted to. So this will give us our head. That's the first thing that we must calculate. In this example, we've measured this from there to there and we found that it's 1.5 meters. In order to compensate for the friction in the pipes, we're going to add another 20% to that head. So 1.5 multiplied by 1.2 in order to add the 20% will give us 1.92. So that's the head that we'll use in order to select the pump. For our example, let's use 15 liters per hour. And let's say we've got 100 of these NFT pipes. So what that will mean is we will take 100, so we've got 100 of these NFT pipes. We're going to multiply that by 15 liter per pipe, so that's 1,500 liter per hour. So we've got our two parameters now. 1,500 liter per hour is our flow, and 1.92 meter is our head. By adding 20% to our measured head, we've also compensated for the friction in the pipes.
Yes.
Now let's use the values that we've got in order to select one of these two pumps. So we've got 1.92 meter head and 1,500 liter per hour flow rate. So 1,500 liter we'll find here on this line, and then 1.92 should be somewhere around there. So we'll just follow that. So that will be our operating point with those parameters. We can see that the bottom pump, the DDF50, will not be able to deliver enough water at that head. Let's have a look. At 1,500 liter per hour, it will only be able to lift the water about 1.4 meters. So that's not sufficient for us. So we must go for the bigger pump. Now the bigger pump will be, let's see, 1,500 liters will be able to lift it almost 2.5 meters high. It is always better to select a little bit bigger pump than to go with a pump that will not be able to supply the water at the correct head. Another tip that I can give you is that the pumps are more efficient towards the center of the curve. So in this area, the pumps will be more efficient than in this area or in this area. So if your calculated results fall within this less efficient area, it will be better for you to look for another pump. It's always better to go for a higher quality pump that may be just a little bit more expensive. Remember, in an NFT system, if your pump fails and you're not quick enough to replace the pump, then you will lose your crop. Another factor to consider is the economy side of the pump. Some pumps may lift this amount of water this high and only use, say, 100 watt hours. Another pump will do the same work and maybe use 300 watt hours. So the economy side of the pump is also important. Some of the modern pumps got variable frequency drives inside the pump and are more efficient than other pumps. On your screen right now, you'll find another video that will also help you in your journey. Thank you and bye-bye.